Hello, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Curtis Shadogs, the born but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park closed but not forgotten video, where today we're going to be showing the history of the Runaway Train. Now, this is a brand spanking new coaster in the 90s at Poulton's Park. And this operated for a good few years before being removed. I'm going to share a lot of stats in this video, so stay tuned for all of that, as well as the history on this ride and share my thoughts on the look of this ride. This is probably one of the only coasters to be removed from Poulton's Park in its time. So, very interesting piece of history already, but we're going to get straight into the history on this ride. So before we get started, guys, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, cut notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. Also, guys, make sure you go into the comments down below to comment down below your questions for the 2K sub Q&A. Use the hashtag question before or after your question, and they will all be on that video. We'll be filmed on Christmas Eve. The questions need to be in by 23:59 p.m. on the 23rd of December. Also, guys, go in the description down below. We can subscribe to our Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, and also join the Coaster Chal Discord server where you can interact with me. I'm thinking about doing some one question go videos next year. So if you want to be involved with that, go into the link. Discord server is on there in the description, and you can go and join and be a part of interacting with me on the server. For now, guys, let's have a look at the history of the old classic Runaway Train at Poulton's Park. So the Runaway Train first opened back in 1992, manufactured by a company called Big Country Motioneering. Now, they've produced four roller coasters. All of them have since been dismantled. It was the park's first major attraction, and it was accompanied by a Mirror Maze and the Skydiver in the following year. And this sort of became the trademark edition, which sort of helped towards breaking the 400,000 visitor mark back in 1995. So this ride operated all the way up to 1999, when it was dismantled, ready for the new millennium, replaced by the Stinger roller coaster. And you're probably thinking, those of you who are modern day Poulton's Park fans are thinking, hang on a minute, what's the Stinger? Well, I can actually tell you that the Stinger is actually now known as the Caterpillar. It's been known as the Caterpillar Coaster since 2014 as part of their new Critter Creek area in that year. Now, with this Runaway Train coaster that was replaced by the Stinger in the new millennium, in 2000, the ride had no inversions, and it was a proper powered family coaster. It's a proper classic Runaway Mine Train layout. A mini mine train layout. Now, of course, this was sold over to Dunes Leisure Park in Lincolnshire, located specifically in Mablethorpe, where it operated from around 2003 right up until 2011. Now, Dunes Leisure currently has two roller coasters, Minor Mike and the Roller Coaster, which is the Wacky Worm. So it's not the biggest park in the world, but it did have the classic Runaway Train. The fate of the Runaway Train at Poulton's Park is not yet known. However, the replacement of the Runaway Train with the Stinger helped a new millennium of investments to help make Poulton's Park the park it is today, with thriving rides, brilliant family-themed attractions, and a world-renowned leisure park to suggest that Poulton's Park is the number one destination in the UK. So there we go. That is the history of the Runaway Train at Poulton's Park. 1992 to 1999, Big Country Motioneering manufacturing the ride, gone to Dunes Leisure Park in Mablethorpe from 2003 to 2011. And of course, in its place came the Stinger, which in 2014 was changed into the Caterpillar Coaster for the Critter Creek area. So a big part of the Runaway Train site became the Critter Creek we know and love today. And the Runaway Train is a very historic ride, an historic roller coaster, and it sort of made Poulton's Park what it is today, really. It was one of the first major attractions at the park. And, you know, since the Runaway Train, we've had other major attractions and areas in the park with the likes of Cobra, Edge, Magma, Peppa Pig World, Critter Creek, Lost Kingdom, and of course Tornado Springs next year in March. So, you know, it sort of became the first of many major attractions at the park, and sort of Runaway Train became the sort of benchmark, shall we say, for the next major attractions further down the years, both family, kids attractions and the thrill rides as well. So Poulton's Park really started with the major rides, with the Runaway Train ride, and it sort of continued all the way through, even after the Runaway Train last operated in 1999. And, you know, Poulton's Park wouldn't be the park it was today without those first major attractions, including the Runaway Train. So big shout out to Adventure Aaron for suggesting this video. If you want to get some video suggestions in, go into the description down below. You can suggest your video ideas using the Google Forms link. I've saved them all. They're all being pre-recorded, ready for the new year. And they'll all be coming out hopefully in 2021, which is all so brilliant. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this closed but not forgotten video from the Runaway Train at Poulton's Park. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. And for now, guys, my name is Coast Shell. Keep living the coast life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. I'm cheering on the Rovers tomorrow. Come on, Donny. Take care. Have a Poulton's-tastic day.